السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
السلام ورحمة الله.
Brothers and sisters, سبحان الله, this morning as we were walking into Masjid Sultan Salah al-Din in Shah Alam, this is a beautiful masjid as you can see, one of a kind, mashallah. And what made it even more beautiful that we heard the Imam was reciting of Surah Al-Salah, ayat, wallahi, I didn't want you to finish. So we came to meet the Sheikh, whom we also met yesterday with the Prime Minister, Anwar Ibrahim, Dr. Anwar Ibrahim and the family,
yeah.
Sheikh Abdul Karim, allow me to say Abdul Karim al-Makki,
yeah.
Because mashallah he is born in Mecca, and the beautiful muazzin, amazing azan, Sheikh Muhammad Shakir, am I correct?
Yeah.
So I'm going to kindly request Sheikh Abdul Karim to recite this beautiful ayat of Surah Fussilat, inna alladhina qalu rabbuna allahu thumma istaqamu again. And we have your brothers, Wael Ibrahim, and we have also Mufti Mink. So go to shed some light, if you don't mind, in a few minutes so that the Ummah can benefit out of that. This is a gathering which is surrounded by the angels. Alhamdulillah, shukrullah. And there is so much sakinah descended on us since you started the recitation, mashallah. Bismillah, Shaykh Abdul Karim.
Alhamdulillah, ma shaytan ar-rajim.
إن الذين قالوا ربنا الله ثم استقاموا تتنزل عليهم الملائكة تتنزل عليهم الملائكة ألا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة التي كنتم توعدون.
اللهم صل على
نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ولكم فيها ما تشتهي أنفسكم ولكم فيها ما تدعون.
الله الله
نزلا من غفور رحيم ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إن من المسلمين ولا تستوي الحسنة ولا السيئة ادفع بالتي هي أحسن فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم. وما يلقاها إلا الذين صبروا وما يلقاها عظيم.
ما شاء الله.
وإما ينزغنك من الشيطان نزغ فاستعذ بالله إنه هو السميع العليم.
MashaAllah, Sheikh Abdul Karim, this is amazing. I have a few questions to ask you, but allow me to request Mufti Mink to give us the general meaning in English, beginning from ayah, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا. One ayah at a time. Or, you know what, let's take إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَا اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا and the following two ayahs we have unity of the context. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده وصلى الله وسلم على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. These verses are by far some of the most important verses regarding the istiqama, you know, to straighten oneself and to walk upon that path of steadfastness, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ, those who say that our Lord is Allah, ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا, and then they are steadfast. Steadfast upon the path, it's a very vast meaning, inshallah we may go into some of it. تَتَنَزَّلُ عَلَيْهِمُ الْمَلَائِكَةِ, the angels descend upon them, أَلَّا تَخَافُوا, that they have no fear and they have no reason to fear. وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا, they have no reason to be sad and they will not be saddened. لا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا وأبشروا بالجنة, and they are being given glad tidings of paradise.
Rejoice
with the news of paradise. التي كنتم توعدون, that which you have been promised. And Allah Almighty then says, نحن أولياؤكم في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة. We are your the protectors. We are your protectors. The term ولي and أولياء refers to the protection. We are the protectors in this world and the next. وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَشْتَهِي أَنفُسُكُمْ وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ, for you is whatever your soul desires. And this is because of the istiqama, because of the steadfastness that happened during their lives. This is their recompense. At the point of death, they are already given good and glad tidings. And Allah says, وَلَكُمْ فِيهَا مَا تَدَّعُونَ نُزُلًا مِنْ غَفُورِ الرَّحِيمِ, what a wonderful place given to them by the one who is the most merciful and the most forgiving. The most forgiving and the most merciful. So this, inshallah, is just the gist of what was read, and we will, inshallah, hear further explanation.
So basically, this glad tidings and the good news will be delivered by the angels of death at the time of death. When they say, نَحْنُ أولياؤكم, when they come to the person who is expiring to crown his life, which was full of istiqama, steadfastness and good deeds, and now it is time to be rewarded. So they assure, لا تخافوا, concerning what you're approaching. You're approaching Jannat, you're approaching forgiveness. ولا تحزنوا, don't you be grieved concerning what you're leaving behind. Don't you worry about your family members, your children, or your wives, because Allah is going to take care of all of that. لا تخافوا ولا تحزنوا, do not be afraid of the future, and do not grieve concerning what you're leaving behind. Then the third, وَأَبْشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُوا, this is the bishara at the time which is needed most. And that's why we see, Brother Wael, some people at the time of death, they're smiling, because they see what we cannot see. In Surah Al-Waqi'ah, the Almighty Allah says, وَنَحْنُ أَقْرَبُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْكُمْ وَلَكِنْ لَا تُبَصِرُونَ, يعني our angels of mercy or otherwise are nearer to the person who's dying than even his family members who are surrounding him. But you cannot see them. Only him or her at the time of expiring, they see. So they either rejoice or they will be frightened. So inshallah, may Allah make us among those whom Allah will send the angels of mercy to say, لَا تَخَافُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَبِشِرُوا بِالْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي كُنْتُمْ تُوَعَدُونَ. One question for you, Wael Ibrahim.
I just want to make a comment before the questions come. SubhanAllah, JazakAllah khair, may Allah bless you. You moved us, wallahi, so much. May Allah bless you, Ya Rabbi. This is one of the most comforting ayah in the Quran for me. Because sometimes we need support from people, we need help, and sometimes we feel alone. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is promising here for those who affirm the faith in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and remain upon that path until the end, that there will be no supporter other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself, yeah, and his angels. So it's, yeah, absolutely in the most critical time of our existence,
mm,
Allah is giving us those this good news.
Assurance.
Alhamdulillah.
So that means not everyone will get to hear the same.
Yeah, there are conditions.
Yeah, so people who say, I'm going to say La ilaha illallah at the time of death, because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, whosoever's last statement before expiring will be La ilaha illallah, they shall go straight to heaven. But in Surah Ibrahim, Allah says, يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Not everyone. Can you shed some light on that, please?
So this is what I was actually talking last night about this istiqama, and the man who came to the Prophet
sallallahu alaihi wasallam,
and he sought after an advice, and he said, like, give me an advice that we never ask anyone after you. Like, I want the best. So the Prophet summarized this ayah by saying, قُلْ رَبِّيَ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقِمْ ثُمَّ اسْتَقِمْ. So first you believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First you say and acknowledge that there is no God worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then remain firm upon that. I remember some of the mashayikh were saying, الْعِبْرَ لَيْسَتْ بِمَنْ سَبَقْ الْعِبْرَ بِمَنْ ثَبَتْ. So Allah will not determine your destiny, whether in Jannah or وَلَيَذْ بِلَا, the opposite destination, just because you began to practice Islam before others, rather by your level of others being steadfast upon the straight path.
Sheikh Abdul Karim, my experience with the Masjid Sultan Salahuddin goes back to maybe 10 years ago. We were driving on the highway. They would show me around and say, this area is called Sheikh Alam. Then on the highway, I heard the sound of Sheikh Al-Husri. It was after Asr, and between Asr and Maghrib. So with sunset, I heard the sound of Sheikh Al-Husri. It was echoing everywhere on the highway. So I asked the driver to stop. And I got off the car and I said, where the sound is coming from? They said, normally they play Sheikh Al-Husri in Masjid Sultan Salahuddin. I said, can you take me there? And when I came here, every time I come to Malaysia, even if I'm staying in Kota Rajaya, I ask them, can you bring me to Sheikh Alam Masjid? Salatul Fajr here is amazing. And I'm one of the luckiest people to meet the person behind this amazing and beautiful melodious sound.
It was not Sheikh Al-Husri.
Well, I'm not sure whether he actually lay Sheikh Al-Husri, actually, because I think it was Sheikh Al-Husri. Okay. Mm-hmm. Do you guys play Sheikh Al-Husri at certain times here?
ممكن بالعربية أنا طبعا لا ممكن ترجم بالعربية بارك الله فيك.
أوكي نعم. أنا كنت أقول يعني من سنوات من 10 سنوات وأنا على الطريق سمعت تلاوة الشيخ الحصري فقلت للسائق توقف, إيه الصوت ده جاء منين؟ قالوا مسجد السلطان صلاح الدين. قلت أريد أن أذهب هنا, فعلمت أنهم يشغلون الشيخ الحصري يعني قبل الغروب بين العصر والمغرب, فسمعت صوت الشيخ الحصري في الآفاق. تفضل.
عندنا بارك الله فيكم سماحة الشيخ, حياكم الله جميعا,
بارك الله فيكم
المبارك.
آمين.
طبعا ليلة البارحة ما أدركنا نتكلم لأن يمكن الوقت غير متسع,
لكني رأيت حسن خطك.
نعم, فالخير فيما اختاره الله. طبعا الله جمعنا هذا الصباح المبارك, أشكركم جميعا فضيلة الشيخ مفتي. طبعا مسجد سلطان صلاح الدين من أيام سلطان صلاح الدين والد السلطان حاليا كان دائما يحب يسمع قبل الأذان ب15 دقيقة حتى يعرفوا الجماعة حوالين المسجد أن قرب صلاة المغرب, حتى اللي بيأخذ رياضة وجهز أموره.
لماذا الشيخ الحصري؟
والله جرى العرف عندنا معروف بالشيخ الحصري.
الله
نعم, وايضا بعض نعم شيخ القراء.
نعم,
فلذلك انا منذ الصغر دائما استمع الى تلاوه الشيخ خليل الحصري مع انني ما ادركته. كان الوالد حريص على ان استمع القران وانا منذ الصغر
ما شاء الله,
لذلك انا حبيت قراءه الشيخ الحصري وحاول اتقمص تلاوته منذ الصغر, وإلى الآن دائما يعني أحب أقرأ لأنه هو متقن في التجويد مخارج الحروف. فمن أراد أن يقرأ القرآن بالتجويد السليم استمع إلى الشيخ.
شيخ عبد الكريم is saying basically 15 minutes before the Adhan they play Sheikh Al-Husri because he's the best قارئ, and his sound, his voice echoes everywhere and people enjoy listening to his recitation because he is the most proficient reciter and people love him here in Malaysia. MashaAllah. I know that Sheikh Abdul Karim is graduated from King Saud University.
Yeah.
And you're born and raised in Mecca. Yeah. So why are you wearing Azhari outfit? قلي ليه انت لابس العمامة والكاكولة؟
طبعا عندنا هنا بارك الله فيكم الزي الرسمي للأئمة باللبس الأزهري, لكن عادة ألبس أيضا بشت لكن حسب الوقت. لكن اللبس الرسمي والزي الرسمي للمسجد سلطان صلاح الدين هو الزي الأزهري. نعم,
جزاكم الله خيرا. نحن أخذنا كثير من وقتكم, ولكن شيخ منك ما ما رأيك لسمعنا الأذان الجميل أو كان يصلي على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم شيخ شوقي أحمد شوقي؟
والله كان الصوت جميل صح. جدا رائع
خاصة الصلاة على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
Let me just say it in English. We heard earlier some of the Adhan, the Salawat and so on. Absolutely amazing voice. Perhaps if he doesn't mind, we can ask him for the viewers just to listen to this, the beauty of it. And inshallah, with that, we will also say the salawat, inshallah. Barakallah fi.
ممكن شيخ الصلوات إن شاء الله. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. كما فعلت بعد الصلاة.
ممكن الصلاة هو أنا اللي
خلقها. طيب نسمح تفضل. اللهم محمد الآن الصلوات
نعم. اللهم ارحمنا بالقرآن واجعله لنا إماما ونورا وهدى ورحمة. اللهم ذكرنا منه ما نسينا وعلمنا منه ما جهلنا وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وأطراف النهار واجعله لنا حجة يا رب العالمين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم.
جزاك الله خيرا لأخي منك. Before we leave, one thing. How can we ever leave without shedding some light on the beautiful ayah ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين.
Every single one of us is duty bound to convey the message of the deen of Allah. Every single one of us, it is part of our faith that we convey. So Allah Almighty is saying, who can there be better in statement, in utterances, than the one who says, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِنْ مَنْ دَعَى, the one who calls towards Allah, إِلَى اللَّهِ, the one who calls towards, there can be no one better in statement than someone who's inviting others towards Allah. The reward of that invitation alone, whether the people are guided or not, is already registered. And if they are guided, it is multiplied. لَأَنْ يَهْدِيَ اللَّهُ بِكَ رَجُلًا وَاحِدًا خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ حُمْرِ النَّعَمِ. If Allah uses you to guide a single person, it's better for you than the most expensive of the
camels,
of the camels, of the red camel, the conveyance of the time. وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. And the person says, I am from among the Muslimin. That part, the end, is probably the most interesting for me as we witness what's happening today on the globe. Each person says, I belong here, I belong there, I belong there, I belong there. This verse says, وَقَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. The condition of you being the best of those who say things and who invite towards Allah is that you identify as a Muslim, member of the Ummah, أَشْهَدُ أَن لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وأشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. And there is no harm in teaching that which we believe is the most correct. But to divide the ummah into pieces and segments and fragments and destroy them completely is very dangerous.
And there is another condition, which is وعمل صالحة.
Yes.
You know, it is not sufficient to be the greatest speaker. You yourself have to practice what you preach.
And you have to do good deeds. You have to do the best. You know the previous verse where Allah says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا رَبُّنَ اللَّهُ ثُمَّ اسْتَقَامُوا.
عمل.
He, yes. It is the deeds. And he ends it by saying, نُزُلًا مِنْ غَفُورِ رحيم.
Allah.
That this abode in paradise is given to you by the one who is Ghafoor Rahim. That Ghafoor Rahim, those two qualities are amazing qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's saying the one who is forgiving. Why does he say the one who's forgiving? So that a sinful slave has hope in the mercy of Allah.
Yeah.
Because if we didn't have a Lord who was forgiving, the minute you made one mistake, it's over. You feel despondent. Allah says, don't feel despondent. Nuzulan min man min ghafoorin. Rahim, the one who loves you, he has mercy on you,
Allah,
and he is very forgiving. So as much as we must practice to the best of our abilities, whatever we are supposed to, if you have faltered dilly-dally, don't let yourself lose hope. Keep going, and Allah will bless you. May Allah make
Allah,
it easy.
I'm really willing to sit here for hours, till dhuhr, listening to the beautiful recitation and the salah ala nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the explanation. But we don't want to make it long for you, brothers and sisters. We shall meet again, inshallah, by the leave of the Almighty Allah. So conclude by asking the Almighty Allah to pardon us all and to forgive us all our sins. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa kaffir anna sayyatina wa tawaffana ma'al abrar. Allahumma hayyi lana min amrina rashada wa ja'alna min abidika su'ada. Allahumma aghfir lana ma qaddamna wa ma akharna wa ma asrarna wa ma a'lanna wa ma anta a'lamu bihi minna. أنت المقدم وأنت المؤخر لا إله إلا أنت أنت حسبنا ونعم الوكيل ونعم المولى ونعم النصير ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذريتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم اجعل تجمعنا هذا تجمعا مرحوما واجعل تفرقنا من بعده تفرقا معصوما ولا تدع فينا ولا منا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وسلام على المرسلين وصلى الله على سيد الأولين والآخرين نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين.